Mr. President, ladies and gentlemen, dear colleagues, good afternoon, everyone. I'm very honored to be here today to receive the Guido Rufino Prize, and thank you very much for the opportunity to share my experience with you. Sorry for my English. I'm sure I can count on your benevolence. And so I am here to receive a prize. And in some ways, this embarrasses me because I know where I started. Look at smoking is dangerous. Smoking. And because I know how many doubts, difficulties, and fears I still have. But if I get such a significant prize, it means that I might have done something in all this year instead of studying English. But I also feel proud about this prize because it represents for me a recognition of an incredible, exciting pathway of growth. Thank you. Thanks to all the people who accompanied me during this long journey. I understand that I'm not an easy person to deal with. Thanks to all the many Italian diabetologists who supported me, and among all, let me remember Aldo Maldonato, Valerio Miselli, and my inseparable wife, Maria Pia, diabetologist too, and to most of my patients, especially those who experimented and interpreted our growth together. And thanks, Guido Rufino. Before finishing his medical studies, he had such a great success with students at college that he was pushed to continue the educational dimension and started playing a more and more active role in the field of patient education, becoming for Spain and Portugal an inspirational guide as Montessori was in Italy and Pestalozzi in Switzerland. I met him in Italy in Jesi for the first time in 1994. What impressed me about him was his respect of the values of the other, the rights of the other, and respect of the other. And something else struck me, and this was a strange thing in the world of certainties, of the defined planet paths, the importance of intuition. Since the right moment doesn't arrive by chance, it is the result of a long pathway of observation and love. And then it is intuition that tells us, yes, now is the right moment. In summary, what is needed? Just some little things. To look at your patient, to take a look at the patient personality, to watch the patient attentively, to be turned toward the patient, to have your eyes fixed on the patient, to look inside the patient, to protect the patient, and to let him express himself. Wow, help me. First lesson learned, the relationship with the patient is complex. And the most lively memory of him comes from one of Grimm's unforgettable meetings where he showed us a book that was and still is for me a reference model, Hemingway, An Old Man and the Sea. Well, the sea is a life master. Insist, navigate, try and try again. And so I sail through the difficulties and satisfaction of the explorers of the world of education. And thanks to the patience, perseverance, and benevolence of Jean-Philippe Assal, I discovered his theater of life, his last fascinating creation, and with his wife Tiziana, he initiated us to it and flanked and supported us in all these years. With Maria Pia, we have reached 26th edition in Sardinia, and we confirm our desire to continue this fantastic experience of the development for doctors and patients. Jean-Philippe's theater allows people to emerge and express an often hidden, disturbing personal life that is often ignored by the healthcare provider, and this could impair care and self-care because it captures and consumes energies and resources. Jean-Philippe's theater of life allows you to transform this personal life into an artwork, where the patient is and recognize himself as the protagonist, thus releasing a propulsive force toward new creative goals. It's creative creation, a gift freedom to creativity in the disease and in the life, and teaches to healthcare providers how to accompany patients in 3 days. It cannot be explained. You can only believe it and try. But what is it? It's theater, medicine, education, therapy. Perhaps none of this individually, but all of them together, yes. It's capable of transforming patient into artist, diabetologists into convincing promoters of art and creativity, artists in master of diabetologists, and much more. All this to respond to the need of that person, which is always an individual and subjective need. And this occurs in diabetes as in many other conditions and disease. A final message: be curious, explore the dimension of the theater of life. There is a book by Jean-Philippe explaining everything about his theater, and above all, lets you understand how art, air, and medicine should live together. Guido Ruffino told me one day, when everything seemed black and impossible, have faith, try and reflect, and start again. Is there something in life that is not a beginning? Well, the theater of life may be a different start. Have faith, so try, reflect, and try again, but please, start. Now, I'm here to receive a prize. What I'm going to do now is to bring back home Guido's energy and commitment to continue and spread the charm of art, medicine, and education together. Thanks to all of you, my fellow colleagues. Thanks to my friend Florian. Thank you, Mr. Florian Totti, the SG president. Thank you all for being here, and keep trying. Thank you, Guido. Grazie, Guido.